By 1999, Matt Groening had dominated the television world with The Simpsons, a comedy about the average family. However, after establishing The Simpsons into pop culture history, Groening wanted to tell a science fiction story from the future, and thus Futurama was born. The series aired on March 28, 1999, and followed the story of Philip J. Fry, a 20th century delivery boy who, upon delivering a pizza to a cryogenics lab, is frozen and awakened into the world of the year 3000. Do you remember when the show first premiered, and how old were you?
I was in my early teens when Futurama first premiered on Fox. I was probably about 13 or 14 years old, definitely just getting out of middle school, starting high school. So in that time, when it first premiered, I was probably in the demographic they were reaching.
Once arrived, Philip J. Fry befriends a disgruntled robot, Bender Bending Rodriguez, discovers his only living relative, Professor Hubert J. Farnsworth, and falls in love with the one-eyed mutant, Taranga Leela. After a disagreement over career chips, Fry, Bender, and Leela find themselves employed by Professor Farnsworth's delivery company, where many adventures will soon ensue. The basic premise of the show was a self-contained adventure that took place every episode, in which the crew would mostly deliver a package to a strange planet. As the show progressed, so did the characters, each one developing throughout the series as we learned more about them. The show ran strong at first, not a major success, but still a favorite among fans. However, tragedy struck on September 11th, 2001, with the terrorist attacks on the U.S.
Do you believe 9/11 had any effect on the show's cancellation?
Oh gosh, yes. 9/11 was a casualty of all kinds of shows.
So,
the regular scheduled programming wasn't there. So I think that any show that premiered during that time was very difficult to keep consistent and keep going because it was simply not in the national mindset to be laughing. That's something that people just were not ready to do.
Before the 2003 season, Fox had made the decision to shut down production of the show. While new episodes still aired, they were sporadic and would often go months in between airings. By this time, Fox cared little about the show, and if a baseball game ran over on their scheduling time, they would simply pick it up where it left off, sometimes leaving the show with only a few minutes left of the episode. From 2002 to 2008, Futurama aired in syndication on Cartoon Network's Adult Swim. In 2005, Comedy Central purchased the rights to syndication to start in 2008. This would be the first steps to reviving the show. During negotiations of the rights between Fox and Comedy Central, Fox brought up the possibility of producing new episodes along with the reruns. At the time, the idea of producing two or three direct-to-DVD movies was already floating around. So to put the two ideas together, Comedy Central ordered 16 new episodes, and the four films were born. This was a major step for the show, bringing back all the original voice cast, as well as many of the original creative team. The four movies were released throughout 2007 to 2009, and were later aired on Comedy Central as four-part episodes. By the time the four films came out, there was no announcements of any further production orders, so the fourth film was supposed to serve as the grand series finale. However, Groening wasn't giving up yet as he continued to express desire to continue the series. Then, after years of waiting, on June 9, 2009, Fox announced that Comedy Central had picked up the show for 26 all-new episodes to begin in 2010, and that all the original cast would be returning as well. July 17, 2009, however, after not complying with their salary demands, Fox posted a casting notice to replace the entire cast. This caused great distress among the fans, as thoughts of a completely different Futurama popped into our heads. Thankfully, though, things quickly worked themselves out as the salary problem was resolved, and it was officially announced that the entire cast was returning. After the cast was signed and the production was underway, all that was left for us fans to do was wait. With each clip that was posted and every teaser that was released, our anticipations grew and grew. When the day finally arrived, 2.9 million viewers tuned in as Futurama was reborn with the appropriately titled episode, Rebirth. with the first episode setting things back normal, and then the second episode returning to the regular routine of the show, it seemed that Futurama was back on track and just as strong as before. So what awaits the show in the future? Will Futurama be even bigger than it was before? Will Fry and Leela finally be together? The answer?
Good news, everyone! Good news, everyone! Oh, great news, everyone! Good news, everyone! Good news, everyone! Good news, everyone! Good news, anyone!